What's up, guys? Back here on the server. Long time no video. We have the soybeans are planted. Started making headlands on corn. But I think we're gonna do a little bit of logging here. I just demoed this thing. I didn't really like it. So we're gonna go ahead and lease our scorpion. Here we go. And then we're gonna make our cutting length to 11 meters, because that's what about the biggest you can fit inside the rail car. Just field 11, and we planted most of it to hay. I believe Jake bought a couple pigs. We were doing pigs for a little bit, but it just wasn't as profitable as we would like. You know, a fully mature pig only goes for about $1,200, and it costs, you know, 13,000 to rent the livestock trailer, so it's not really it's pretty high maintenance and they use a lot of grain. So we switched to sheep, a little bit slower production, a little bit slower pallet production, but all you do is give them grass and water, and they produce wool. So I believe we have 15, 16 sheep or something like that right now. We have plenty of hay, and then we planted trees. You can see them right up ahead of, right in front of us, towards the tracks. We did 11 rows, I think, maybe 11 rows, maybe more. So there's like 110, 120 trees that we planted. So hopefully we get a decent amount of money, at least enough to justify renting this scorpion. Basically, the goals of the tree is to not only pay for the scorpion, pay off our loans, but hopefully have a decent amount of cash left over so we can invest in maybe some new equipment or more sheep. I also believe, so here's one of the piles that I think Jake made of our grass, and I think he has the disc vine over there, bought the disc vine. So these are all the trees we planted. Switch to my joysticks now. And we're cutting these to 11 meters because that's the size of the lumber rail car. And then what we'll probably end up doing is just getting our front end loader with the log grapple. Cutting these to 11 meters should fit just fine in the rail car. Kind of want to see what my residue, my leftover pieces are. Yeah, so that's pretty good. We're not leaving too much on the ground. We're using up these whole trees, so 11 meters will be a good, good cut. Might as well take out these pine trees while we're here. They won't be 11 meters, but... still put them on the train. So I think I'll end up so I imagine we can get probably 10 or so, maybe more, in the rail car, 10 trees. We could probably do two lanes out at once. Can't do much with that little piece. Thank you. should probably run and get the train eventually. So each of these sections is probably worth about 1,000 based on our previous experience. We're pretty darn close to it. So I think we should be sitting pretty good once we get a couple of these train loads in. You know, this is probably close to probably getting close to a full wagon right there. So you can see we're gonna be here a while with the cutting down these trees. Definitely need a big payday with these trees. We used to do this by hand using the chainsaw and then trying to delimb them manually. But you need a guy, you need to kind of bring the log next to the log trailer and then have a guy trim off the tip to make sure it fit. Now we can just cut to size, delimb the entire tree, and then all we have to do is have a couple guys come with loaders and load up the train. So it's a little bit more efficient way of doing things. Definitely more expensive, for sure. But we should be able to pay for the operation. This scorpion. a little bit chaotic when the trees are this close to one another, but still cutting at 11. So what I think we're gonna do is I'm gonna go grab the train, which I believe is over here. Bring it over and see how the front loader does on these logs. I don't want to cut too many, and you know, it might be easier to break it, you know, cut it down to 10 meters, a little bit shorter. They should fit in this rail car with room to spare. Let's see our tree operation. This off the auger. Down to our logs and see how this goes. Big weight on the back. Really keep the scorpion cutting the whole time, but and then probably use a front end loader to load these up. But we'll see what all we can do. You can see we're cutting at 11 meters and there's plenty of room for these guys to why I'd maybe consider cutting it down to 10 is because of situations like this where they're not perfectly lined up. It'd be better to get the front end loader. But can't really afford it right now, that's the problem. Thank you. Alright guys, I'll probably end the video here and then maybe we can pick up when we have more help on the server so we don't waste our Scorpion rental. So thanks for watching.